Hi, I'm Tom. This is Measuring with Tom, episode 2. Today we'll be measuring a sheet of A4 paper, the kind of paper you might use in a photocopier or a printer, or just for writing on. This is standard paper here. First thing you need to do is open it up. Choose a piece, any piece you want. I'm going to go with the third piece, which you're, and a fourth, and you two, that's fine. If you lay them on top of each other directly, just move this out of the way, then I think you'll find the measurements will be the same, so they're not going to cause any problems here. Put that in the middle of your area, in a nice flat surface, as before, as I showed you last week, to lay it on. So, we're going to do the long edge first. I'm going to use this ruler again. Yeah, this is exactly the length of the paper, I mean, well, give or take. If you can see the measurements there, they're backwards because I've got it upside down, but now we've got it in position, I think we can read that fine. It only goes from 1 to 26 in the middle of this one, so there's a little of an edge at each edge there that isn't being measured, but that's not a problem. What we can do is if we were to go, let's just make a mark that it's the 26 centimetres, and what we can do if we leave that in place, we can take another ruler and just measure the edge that's here. That's 2.5. 2.5 there. 2.5 centimetres. This at this end is 1 centimetre. And you just need to add all those up in order to get the full length. So let's see. 29.5 centimetres there. And now we're going to link along the top. And for this, I'm going to start it on the edge. All the way along, that looks like 21. You can measure this edge as well. It's a good tip if you're not 100% sure about your accuracy. You can measure this edge as well. The two should be the same. That one is 21. That's 21 on that end. So that's 21. So there's your final measurements there. 21 by 29.5. We don't need these anymore. It was just for the addition. Right, finished measurements of the A4 piece of paper. So that's the measuring complete now. I think you'll find those measurements should be typical of any A4 piece of paper. If you're measuring at home and you find you have a different measurement, you might want to just check. If you're in the United States, you might find it's a slightly different size. And if you notice that one of the measurements is correct, but the other one is roughly half the size of that, then you might have got yourself a sheet of A5 there, by mistake. Okay. That's it for today. I hope you've enjoyed the show. It's been informative, and I'll see you again next week.